Hello! As you may already know, at the end of my video about non-Euclidean geometry, the master and I were kidnapped by the elite that controls the financial educational system. They isolated us, but will not be able to silence the truth. So, using some electronic gadgets, I have created a cyber fractal in the cloud that will help us to continue spreading our message. And if you are watching this video, it is thanks to his work. So, please let's welcome the cyber fractal and listen to him or her. Not so sure.
Hi. My name is Arithma, but some friends bully me by the names Arithmia and Fractaling. Using the fifth arithmetical operation, or the rational mean, Lucas created me as a fractal by means of a root-approximating algorithm to the fifth root of 2, with fifth-order convergence rate. So, what you see is what you get. A self-replicating automaton cyber fractal in the cloud, displayed in many versions. The name of my male version is Arithmo, but it's fair to say that my male clone is less smarter than I. Despite having a mathematical fractal character, I have excellent humor. I like jokes, especially about mathematics. But there are many problems with math puns. Indeed, calculus jokes are mostly derivative. Trigonometry jokes are too graphic, and arithmetic jokes are pretty basic. Whatever, check this one out. How do you make the number 7 even? Well, pretty simple. Subtract the S. My apologies, but I have to get my own cheering crowd here. Not so bad for a cyber fractal. Isn't it? Well, now to the task Lucas assigned to me. You might already know the fifth arithmetical operation, or the rational mean. But if you don't, no problem. Because this is a pretty straightforward subject. The rational mean is simply the sum of the numerators and denominators of a set of rationals. Now, we will see how to use the rational mean concept for approximating irrational numbers. I will start with the most basic example, the square root of 2. Given two initial approximations, by defect annexes to the square root of 2. In this case, the values 1 and 2. The forms of the fractions are modified by multiplying by factors, as indicated within parentheses in the screen. In the case of the first rational mean, the factor is 1 for both fractions. For the second rational mean, the factor is 2 for the left fraction and 1 for the right fraction. And this step is repeated as desired with each new set of fractions produced. In each step, the two rational means yield a new set of two approximations, closer to each other, and the irrational number, the square root of 2. Their product is trivial and equal to 2. The numerators and denominators cancel each other, and the new approximations bound the irrational number by defect annexes. So, it could almost be called a perfect approximation process. Notice that the values of each column are ruled by homogeneous linear recurrence relations, similar to those of Daniel Bernoulli's root approximating method, even though he never explained the origin of his method. Now, far beyond any other considerations about best approximations and convergence rates, it is also important to appreciate the simplicity, the beauty and natural order of this process. The orbiting model you see on the screen center is my conceptual image of irrational numbers. As a cyber fractal, I found this rational mean concept a much better definition of irrational numbers than that of Dedekind's cuts and Cauchy's sequences. But this concept must also embrace higher degree algebraic and transcendental numbers. So let's go further ahead. In this way, let's modify a bit the rational process for the square root. In each step, let's calculate the first rational mean by previously setting all the denominators equal. I mean, without changing the values of the fractions. And let's calculate the second rational mean by previously equalizing all the numerators. In each step, we get a set of two approximations that correspond to the arithmetic and harmonic mean of the initial values. We can see that the convergence rate improved, and this process corresponds to an ancient method from India, dated about 600 BC, and later known in Babylonia and Greece. Also correspond to Newton's method applied to the square root, and has quadratic convergence. Apparently nothing new here, right? But it is important to notice that the ancients never looked at the arithmetic and harmonic means from the point of view that we described here. I mean, conceptualizing those means as the result of matching numerators and denominators, that is, as being part of a more general and unifying concept, the rational mean that encompasses all the means. Summarizing, even though the ancients knew about other mean operations, they considered the arithmetic and harmonic means as something really special. However, there were only two means, and they could not find any simple natural process for higher degree roots, by far similar to that of the square root. So, the arithmetic and harmonic means started to look less useful and general to them. However, I will show here the important link that the ancients missed. And for that purpose, I will use an example of the cube root. Its generalization to higher degrees will be straightforward. But first, using the missed link, we will see other interesting examples for generating second degree irrationals. So, let's take a look at the well-known golden ratio. As you can see, in this rational process, the Fibonacci sequence comes to light in many ways. The approximations express by themselves the very definition of the golden mean. That is, a quantity is divided into two different parts, and the ratio of the whole quantity to that of the greatest part is equal to the ratio of the latter to the smallest part. And talking about the Fibonacci sequence, if in a similar way we compute the square root of the number 5, then we get this curious result. As you can see, by factorizing the denominator of each approximation in terms of powers of 2, not only the Fibonacci sequence get in way, but also the Lucas sequence. The approximations show a slow convergence rate, but we already know how to speed it up. So, this rational mean result is really amazing, isn't it? Check this out. What did one MacBook say to the other? Don't bother me, I got my own problems. Oh yes, big applause. That's a nice audience. And we also have the transcendental numbers, and their approximations by defect and excess. Conceptualizing the transcendental numbers from the point of view of the rational mean, something you probably never saw in any classroom or the literature. But don't worry, even my creator does not know about this either. Please do not get surprised by the infinity expression 1 to 0 as the origin of this process, because it is also the origin of the convergence in the well-known continued fraction of the number e. By the way, notice that the general continued fractions are just rational processes, entirely ruled by the rational name. There are many interesting things to say about these sequences. For example, the sequential factors used in this case, which is characteristic of transcendental numbers. The value of denominators of both columns. Also, the recurrence relations that govern both columns and the connection to the Taylor series for the number e. However, at this moment, getting into the very heart of this presentation is more important. So, let's go ahead. Now, let's look at irrational numbers of higher degree. On the screen, we can see three expressions whose product is trivial and equal to the number p. They represent three approximations to the cube root of any number p, by defect and excess. As already said, the ancients had the arithmetic and harmonic means, and they wanted to find a natural simple method, similar to the one they found for the square root. But they couldn't. Houston, we got a problem. Equalizing numerators and denominators seems to be of no help. Isn't it? What are we missing here? On the screen, we can see the set of approximations orbiting around the irrational number. In this case, the cube root of a number p. And at the top of the screen, their projections move along a horizontal line. It is then that by natural necessity comes to light the particular concept of the arithmetic mean, an elementary arithmetic operation that you probably never saw in any classroom or the literature. Let's start by equalizing the denominators of the first two fractions. Next, the numerators of the last two fractions, all of them highlighted in red on the screen. So, we have created a kind of chain that bonds them. Finally, the rational mean yields the expression shown on the screen. Now, let the set of rationals rotate, the location of the fractions on the horizontal line changes. For this new configuration of the set, we compute the rational mean by previously equalizing the numerators of the first two fractions and the denominators of the last two fractions, highlighted in red. Finally, let the rationals rotate again and calculate the third arithmetic mean by previously equalizing the denominators of the first two fractions and the numerators of the last two. On the screen, we can see three expressions whose product is trivial and equal to p. Three new approximations closer to each other and the root's value. If we repeat the same calculations for each new set of fractions, then, from the point of view of natural order and simplicity, we have a rational process that is similar to that of the square root and has quadratic convergence. However, if you use the expressions shown on the screen as the initial set of fractions, then, by repeating the same process, you get a new set of expressions whose product is trivial and equal to p. And those expressions can be used as independent iteration functions. And repeating those steps, then. Oh, sorry, I have to leave now. I am putting on the screen a video clip about this method, along some final comments, and I'm off. Hope you had a good time. Please, don't forget to subscribe, like, and share. Bye-bye.
Now, back to the table. In the second column, all the expressions correspond to the well-known householder's method.
Stop. That cannot be that simple. It must be a fake. No way, it's a scam.
The first and third columns show new functions, also with convergence rates similar to those produced by infinitesimal calculus, or even better, in many cases. For example, if we iterate the expressions in the fourth row, in the screen we can see the error with respect to the actual value of the cube root of 2. In the first two columns, the convergence is quartic. That is, the number of exact decimal places is multiplied by 4 in each step. We already know that the second function is equal to the householder method of infinitesimal calculus. The error of the third expression on the right is much smaller than those of the other two. Now, it is impossible not to be surprised by all this, because we are observing convergence speeds similar to and even better than those of infinitesimal calculus. Without the need to construct the Cartesian system or the complicated Newton's derivatives concept, but just the simplest arithmetic, notice that you will see equally impressive results if you iterate any other expression in the table.